This is Janet Androvier.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to indicate the direction of the current induced in the rod using Lenz's law. Determine the expression of the magnetic flux crossing the swept area. Calculate the values of the electromotive force and the electric current induced in the rod. Calculate the magnitudes of the Laplace force and the motive force acting on the rod. Calculate the thermal power dissipated in the resistor.
A resistor of resistance 2.2 ohms is connected between two long parallel conducting rails QP and MN. The circuit is placed in the horizontal plane in the region of a uniform magnetic field B of magnitude 0.2 tesla and of direction perpendicular to the plane of the rails. A horizontal straight metal rod CD of length 10 centimeters moves between the two rails with a horizontal velocity V of constant magnitude 0.5 meters per second under the action of a horizontal constant force F of magnitude F. The figure is a diagram of the top view of the circuit. So as shown, the magnetic field vector is drawn as a cross in each position. Neglect the resistance of the rails and assume that the internal resistance of the rod is 0.3 ohms. The friction force F is directed opposite to V and has a constant magnitude of 2 times 10 to the power minus 5 newtons. At T0 equals 0, the center of mass G of the rod is at the origin O of the x-axis.
Number 1. Specify the chosen positive sense in the circuit. The positive sense is determined by referring to the direction of the unit vector n. This figure shows that n is denoted by the symbol cross, so n is directed inward. Then, when curling the fingers of the right hand, the thumb of this hand is pointed inward. Therefore, these fingers must curl in the clockwise sense, which represent the positive sense. Question number 2. Indicate the name of the phenomenon that takes place in the above circuit and apply Lenz's law to determine the direction of the induced current in the circuit. The name of the phenomenon is called electromagnetic induction. Now we have to apply Lenz's law to determine the direction of the current. So we have 2 steps. First step, we determine the direction of the Laplace force. Second step, we use the right-hand rule to determine the direction of the induced current. Let's start with the first step. We know that when a straight conductor carries a current and placed in an external magnetic field, this conductor is submitted to a force called Laplace force. According to Lenz's law, the Laplace force is directed horizontally to the left to resist the motion of the wire CD or to oppose the cause that produces the current. So, the Laplace force is directed horizontally to the left as shown on the figure. Now, let's move to the second step, or applying the right-hand rule. We observe that the external magnetic field is directed inward, and pay attention, we refer to the external magnetic field and not to the induced magnetic field. And the Laplace force is directed horizontally to the left. Now, we put the right hand on the rod CD so that the fingers of this hand are directed inward and the palm of the right hand faces the left side or the middle finger of the right hand pointed to the left. We notice that the thumb points from D to C. That means the induced current in the circuit is directed from D to C in the rod.
Let's move to part 3. Determine the expression of the magnetic flux crossing the closed circuit in terms of B, L, V, and the time T. The expression of the magnetic flux crossing a surface due to a uniform magnetic field is S B dot N. B dot N is equal to the magnitude of B times the magnitude of N, which is equal to 1, times cosine the angle between B and N. Now, look at the figure. N is directed inwards and B is also inwards, so the angle between them is zero. Now, the area S of the closed circuit is QC, the length, times CD, the width, because this area has a rectangular shape. Now, QC is equal to the abscessa of the center of mass of the rod, and CD is equal to L, the length of the rod. So, S is equal to L times X. Now, replace the angle by 0 and S by LX. This is going to be phi is equal to BLX cosine 0, which is equal to BLX. Now, but we want the expression of the magnetic flux in terms of B, L, V, and T. So here, we must replace X by V and T. Now, in the beginning of the question, we said that the rod moves with a constant velocity, which means that it moves in a uniform rectilinear motion. The time equation of a uniform rectilinear motion is x equal vt plus x0. Now, what is x0? Also, in the beginning of the question, we said that at t0 equals 0, the center of mass of the rod coincides with the origin O of the x-axis, so the initial abscessa of the center of mass of the rod is 0. Then x0 is equal to 0, which means that phi is equal to BLVT, so we replaced x by VT. Now, this is the expression of phi in terms of B, L, V, and T. Let's move to part 4. Calculate the value of the electromotive force E induced in the circuit. We calculate E from Faraday's law. So, E is equal to minus d phi by dt. Now, we need to differentiate this expression with respect to time. You know that B is constant, L is constant, and V is constant because the rod moves with a constant velocity. Then the derivative of BLVT with respect to time is BLV, which means that E is equal to minus BLV. Now, let's calculate the value of E. The magnitude of B is 0.2 Tesla, and the length of the rod is 0.1 meters, and the speed is 0.5 meters per second, and the answer is minus 0.01 volts.
Part 5. 5A, deduce the direction of the induced current, and compare this direction to that obtained in part 2. We know that when the rod acts as a generator, or acts as a source of electromotive force, then E times I should be positive. But E is equal to minus 0.01 proved in the previous slide. So E is negative, then I is also negative. Therefore, the direction of the induced current is opposite to the chosen positive sense since I is negative. So I is directed from D to C in the rod. Then we can conclude that the direction of the obtained current is the same as that obtained in part 2. 5b. Deduce that the value of the induced current is equal to minus 4 milliamperes. Using the formula I equal E over the total resistance in the circuit, then substitute each physical quantity by each value. The induced electromotive force is equal to minus 0.01 volt. The resistance of the resistor R is equal to 2.2 ohms, and the internal resistance of the rod is equal to 0.3 ohms. Therefore, the value of the current is equal to minus 4 times 10 to the power minus 3 amperes, which is equal to minus 4 milliamperes.
Let's move to part 6. Calculate the potential difference UQM across the resistor of resistance R. The positive sense flows in the resistor from M to Q. So, UMQ is equal to plus IR. The current is calculated in the previous part. It is minus 4 times 10 to the power minus 3 amperes, and the resistance of the resistor is 2.2 ohms. So UMQ is equal to minus 8.8 times 10 to the power minus 3 volts. But we want UQM. UQM is equal to minus UMQ, which is equal to 8.8 times 10 to the power minus 3 volts. Let's move to part 7a. Calculate the magnitude FL of the Laplace force acting on the wire. The magnitude is given by this expression. The absolute value of I times L B sine the angle between L and B, where L is the vector representing CD oriented in the direction of the current. So, the current or the absolute value of the current is 4 times 10 to the power minus 3 amperes, and the length of CD is 10 centimeters. We divide it by 100, it becomes 0.1 meters. The magnitude of B is 0.2 tesla, and the angle between L and B is 90 degrees. So FL is equal to 8 times 10 to the power minus 5 newtons.
Focus, please. This is important.
7b. Apply Newton's first law to determine the magnitude of the applied force F. We can apply Newton's first law since the center of mass of the rod is in uniform rectilinear motion, or it moves with a constant velocity. So the external forces acting on the rod are its weight mg, the normal forces nc and nd, the friction force F, the Laplace force FL, and the applied force F. And C is a normal force exerted by the rail QP on the rod, and D is a normal force exerted by the rail MN on the rod. But NC and ND can be represented by one normal force N, so that N is equal to NC plus ND. Now, applying Newton's first law. The sum of the external forces acting on the rod is equal to zero vector, or mg plus nc plus nd plus the frictional force F plus FL plus F is equal to zero vector. So project these forces along the x-axis. Since the weight mg, nc and nd are normal to the x-axis, so the projection of these forces along the x-axis becomes zero. Since the direction of the friction force is opposite to the positive x-axis, then the projection of the friction along the x-axis becomes minus F. Similarly, the direction of the Laplace force is opposite to the positive x-axis, then the projection of this force along the x-axis becomes minus FL, and the direction of the applied force is the same as the positive x-axis, so its projection along the axis becomes plus F. Now, replace each physical quantity by each value. The magnitude of the friction force is equal to 2 times 10 to the power minus 5 newtons given at the beginning of this problem. FL, or the magnitude of FL, is equal to 8 times 10 to the power minus 5 newtons is calculated in the previous slide. Then we can conclude that the magnitude of the applied force is equal to 10 to the power minus 4 newtons.
Now, part 7c. Compare the mechanical power of the force F to the total electrical power induced in the circuit. Explain this result. The formula that gives you the mechanical power of a force is P mechanical equal F dot V. The scalar product of two vectors is the product of their magnitudes by the cosine of the angle between them. So we have the magnitude of the force F times the speed times cosine angle between F and V. Replace each physical quantity by its value. So the magnitude of F is 10 to the power minus 4 newtons, and the speed is 0.5 meters per second, and the angle is zero. This is because the rod moves horizontally to the right along the rails under the action of the force F, which is directed horizontally to the right. So F and V have the same direction and the angle between them is zero. This is going to be 5 times 10 to the power minus 5 watts. So this is the mechanical power of the force F. Let's move to the induced total electrical power. P electrical is equal to E times I. We already calculated E and I in the previous parts. So E is equal to minus 0.01 volts and the current is minus 4 times 10 to the power minus 3 amperes. And the answer is 4 times 10 to the power minus 5 watt. Now, how can we explain this result? As you see, the mechanical power is greater than the induced electrical power. This is because during its motion along the rails, the rod is acted upon by the friction force. And the work done by this friction force results in a transformation of part of the mechanical energy into thermal energy. Let's move to part 7D. Calculate the thermal power dissipated in the resistor of resistance R. The formula that gives you the thermal power dissipated in the resistor is P thermal is equal to I squared R. Similarly, we replace each physical quantity by its value. So, we have 4 times 10 to the power minus 3 squared times the resistance, which is 2.2 ohms. And the answer is 3.52 times 10 to the power minus 5 watts. Now, let me explain the power distribution in our problem. So, the rod moves horizontally to the right under the action of the horizontal force F. So, the mechanical power of the force F is P mechanical equal F times V. How is this power distributed? The rod moves under the action of the horizontal force F, but it is acted upon by a friction force, so part of the mechanical power is lost due to the work done by the friction force. The other part is transformed into induced total electrical power in the rod. P electrical is equal to E I. Now, how is the total electrical power induced in the rod distributed in the circuit? Now, you know that the rod has an internal resistance R. R is responsible for the energy loss due to Joule effect, which is the transformation of the electrical energy into thermal energy. So, we have the lost power in the resistance of the rod. The other part of the total induced power is transferred to the exterior circuit. So the useful power, PR is equal to IUQM. Now, even though this power is a thermal power dissipated in the resistor, but relative to the rod, the power IUQM, which is equal to RI squared, is the useful power. Now, take into account that if the rod is not acted upon by friction force, then we don't have a power loss due to friction, and in this case, the mechanical power would be equal to the total electrical power induced in the rod.
Part 8. The area of the circuit QCDM and the magnitude of the magnetic field remain constant, but we rotate all the circuit that is formed by the rails, resistor, and the rod in the horizontal plane about a vertical axis. Specify whether an EMFE is induced in the circuit. Observe the figure. During rotation of the circuit, the unit vector N remains vertically upward, so the angle alpha between B and N remains zero, or this angle does not change. Since alpha doesn't change, the magnitude of the magnetic field doesn't change, and the area of the circuit QCDM doesn't change, then the magnetic flux crossing the circuit doesn't change. Therefore, MEMF is not induced in the circuit. Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.